Hey guys, it's Chris. We got the fifth wheel done. Let's take a look. Okay guys, well, there it is. It's done. It's bolted in. It's good to go. So, let me go ahead and tell y'all what this is. What that is a piece of mounting hardware off of a bed cover gas strut, which I never would have thought of, but it is really, really scale looking. Let me see if I can get that into focus. You know, as far as a scale tow ball. So the hole in the bed, I used just a step drill bit to cut that. Now I will tell you, if you go to do that, make sure you're real careful with that because it'll tear that plastic up and bind it real quick. So just go easy with it. So a couple of things we're gonna have to contend with. The height from the ball to the top of the cage is about 3 inches, right at 3 inches. So that's something you're gonna wanna take into consideration when you're building your gooseneck. This back here from the ball to the back was 3 1/4. And then from the ball to the ground at normal ride height was 7 1/8. Now this distance here, we're just gonna have to wait and see on that. You know, all that's gonna affect is your turning radius. But this is the important one right here, guys, because if the hitch on the trailer end is taller than 3 inches, you're gonna be hitting that bar. And you really can't remove that one. Yeah, I wouldn't. I guess you could, but I wouldn't. So here's what it looks like underneath. Now, you've already seen the video on the mounting plate. I will tell you, I had to work on these holes a little bit, you know. I had to adjust a couple of the holes just so I could have some wiggle room to get that thing straight as I can get it. I did have to put a little spacer in there. Now the spacer actually came out of my bomber parts kit. So word of advice, guys, never throw away your parts trees. I don't care how old they are, keep them. But that's part of the drive shaft. And all I did was cut it down and used it for a spacer, and it worked really, really well. So that's a drive shaft yoke. But anyway, there it is, it's on. And like I said, guys, that's a pretty easy mod to do for these things. You know, a little easier than I thought. Getting it lined up perfectly straight was a little harder than what I thought it was gonna be. A little bit more work. Not, I shouldn't say hard, but a little more work. But anyway, pretty simple. Anybody can do that. So anyway, big plans coming up. We got that done. I should be getting some updated pictures of the trailer's progress this evening. So next step will probably be the dual shocks on the rear. I'll have an episode on just that. I believe I found the parts to get that done. And then we'll move on. I still haven't swapped out the motors. We got to swap out the motors. But we got plans for the trailer too, and some other stuff for the truck, but we'll get into that later down the road. So anyway, if you want to keep up with it, ultimate truck trailer combo, like, share, subscribe. We'll keep putting them up. We'll see you next time.